Hello, my name is Shweta and I am going to explain the GSM architecture. So the contents of our topic is GSM introduction, GSM services and GSM architecture. So what is GSM? GSM is the global system for mobile communication. The first version of GSM is developed by the group of Special Mobile in 1982 at Europe. It is the second generation mobile communication standard. It is the one of the most popular mobile communication standard. As we know, the GSM is 2G architecture. In the 1G architecture, the calls are manually operated. In the 1G architecture, if we want to call any other user, we wanted to call manually. Means one operator always there to operate the call manually. So we know that 2G is GSM architecture. 3G means the UMTS, means Universal Mobile Telecommunication System. 4G stand for LTE, means long term evaluation. Then GSM communication uses a cellular network. The main goal of GSM is to provide a voice services compatible to ISTN or PSTN system. The GSM standard operates in the frequency ranges from 900, 1800 and 1900 megahertz. Then some services are provided by the GSM, that are the teleservices, bearer services and supplementary services. So we'll first see the teleservices. Teleservices are the services offered by a mobile service network to a caller. Some of the teleservices provided by the GSM service providers are telephonic voice at full data rate, fax, SMS, emergency number calls and MMS. MMS supporting the GIF and JPG images. Then second is the bearer services. Bearer services are responsible for transmission of data between two user interfaces. Bearer services provides a voice signal or SMS. In SMS, it includes up to 160 characters using a blank spaces and character. Then third is the supplementary services. The supplementary services are call related services. So we first forget to tell you, in the bearer services, there are two types of services. First is the non-transparent and second is the transparent services. The non-transparent services is that services in which upper layer is not notified, means the services are transferred from physical to physical layer. Other layers are not disturbed during the transmission. Then second is the transparent services, upper layer to all the layers, means while transmission of data, all the layers are notified to that services. Then supplementary services. In the supplementary services, there are the call related services. In the supplementary services, the servicer provides us the call waiting, call hold, call bearing, call forwarding, multi-party grouping. In the call waiting, we get a notification of an incoming call while on the our handset. Then call hold, put a call on hold to take another call. Then on call bearing, all calls contains outgoing or incoming calls. Call forwarding, call can be sent to the various number defined by the user. Multi-party grouping means the call conference links multiple calls together. These all are the services provided by the GSM. Then we see the GSM architecture. This is the architecture of the GSM. The architecture of GSM is contains in the three parts, which is the mobile station, base station subsystem and network subsystem. In this, there are abbreviation for all these phases. Means MS means the mobile station. There is contains two parts, that is ME and SIM. ME is the mobile equipment, SIM is the subscriber identity module. Then second is the base station subsystem, which consists of a BTS and BSC. BTS stands for the base transceiver station and BSC stands for the base station controller. And third is the network subsystem. Network subsystem consists of the MSC, stand for the mobile switching center. HLR stands for the home location register. VLR stand for the visitor location register. AUC stand for the authentication center. and EIR stand for the Equipment Identity Register. Then we will see the mobile station. Means MS. MS is our mobile phones, which consist of two entities. First is mobile equipment and second is SIM. So ME is the mobile equipment. The ME is a portable vehicle mounted handheld device uniquely identified by an IMEI number. IMEI means the International Mobile Equipment Identity Number. Then SIM is the subscriber identity module, which is a smart card contains the International Mobile Subscriber Identity, which is known as the IMSI number. SIM allows user to send and receive calls and receive other subscriber services. It can be protected by a password or a PIN. It can be moved from phone to phone, contain a key information to activate the phone. Then second is the base station subsystem, which consists of the two parts, base transceiver station and second is the base station controller. Then we will see base transceiver station means the BTS. MS communicates with the BTS. BTS is the base transceiver station. It establishes a communication between the MS and BSC. It encodes, encrypts, multiplexes, modulates and feeds the RF signal to the antenna, consists of a transceiver units. It forwards the request to BSC. Then we will see what is the BSC. BSC is the base station controller. It manages the radio resources for the BTS. It assigns a frequency and time slot for all the MSCs in its area. Then it handles in the call setup. It helps in handover for MS. It communicates with MSC and BTS. After BSC, our signal forwarded to MSC. Then there is a network switching subsystem, means the NSS. The system consists of the following functional unit. The first is the mobile switching center. Mobile switching center is the heart of the network. If our call request does not reach to the MSC, then it is not able to connect. It manages the communication between the GSM and other networks. It works for billing information and collection. It works for call setup, call routing, channel allocation, registration, send default messages like user is busy, caller tune setup, location updating and registration. Inter BSC and inter MSC call handoffs are managed by the MSC. Then second is the home location register, which is called as the HLR. HLR stores the information about each subscriber that belongs to its MSC in a permanent or a temporary fashion. As soon as a mobile subscriber leaves its current local area, the information in HLR is updated. HLR database contains IMSI numbers, MSISDN means the mobile number, prepaid or postpaid, whether it is roaming restrictions, whether it provided by the supplementary servicing, that all are managed by the HLR. Then the visitor location register. Each MSC has a visitor location register. In the VLR, temporary database, which updates whenever new MS enter in its area by the HLR database. VLR assign the TMSI means the temporary mobile subscriber identity to each MS entering in the VLR area, which keeps on changing. It controls the mobile roaming in its area. VLR database contains IMSI, MSISDN, location area and authentication key. Then fourth is the AUC. AUC stands for the authentication center. AUC used for the security purposes. It contains algorithm for authentication as well as the keys for encryption. Authentication is a process to verify whether a subscriber is a valid or invalid. It protects network operators from the fraud. It's situated in a special protected part in HLR. Then fifth is the EIR. EIR is the Equipment Identity Register. EIR stores the International Mobile Equipment Identity Number for the entire network. It stores the database that is used to track handset using IMEI number. It prevents calls from stolen, authorized or defective mobile devices. The ELR contains the three type of list. The first is the white list, second is grey list and third is the black list. In the white list, it contains the purchase phone, means authorized customers 4 are contained in the white list. In the grey list, it contains the stolen phone which are under the surveillance. Blacklist, IMEI number which are stolen and not getting back, which are reported as a stolen or currently locked due to some reason, this number is contained in the blacklist. This is the GSM system architecture. So now in this diagram you can see that MS sends the signal to the nearest BTS, then BTS forwarded it to the BSC. Then after some processing, when BSC gets a channel or a time slot, then BSC sends signals to the MSC. Then all the process of authentication is done, then MSC sends the signal to other network. So thank you.